Hello my darlings, it's me Chantal. I am back to review this week's episode of RuPaul Drag Race. So, first of all, let me apologize for not posting anything last week. To celebrate spring, I treated myself by planting opium in Afghanistan. It is my little guilty pleasure. I also spent a few days analyzing ancient bacteria in Antarctica. As I came back, I discovered that Candy Who had been eliminated. Candy Who? Never mind. This week was everybody's favorite episode, Scratch Game. The queens are put in a container filled with mosquitoes and must scratch themselves until they bleed. This week was everybody's favorite, Smash Game. The queens enter individual rooms and must destroy everything as quick as possible. This week was everybody's favorite, Flash Game. The queens walk along Hollywood Boulevard and must untuck and flash as many people as possible without getting arrested. This week was everybody's favorite, Mash Game. The queens must make 50 pounds of mashed potatoes while walking the runway. This week was everybody's favorite, Hatch Game. The queens are abandoned in a secret hatch on a faraway island and must press a button every 108 minutes to prevent the end of the world.
Fuck you, what is it?
This week is everybody's favorite, Snatch Game.
Motherfuck.
So, let's review the contestants. Max chose to be Sharon Needles from season 4. Although her look was perfect, the character made me horribly uncomfortable. There were no jokes and the character was non-existent. Miss Fame was a
boring
Donatella Versace. Poor Miss Fame really missed the mark. She actually sounded more like a retired Russian figure skater than an Italian fashion designer.
Donatella Versace has done boots through. How are you?
Although, I have to say, she nailed the leather skin. I wouldn't mind making myself a handbag with that face. Violet, who was also planning on doing Donatella Versace, chose to be Alyssa Edwards instead, following Rue's advice, who liked to create trouble in this episode. Note that Violet always listened to the judges' suggestions. It is a smart move, if a little bit safe, that got her very far in the competition. I thought she did a fantastic job at portraying Alyssa, and her lack of chin really came in handy. Don't forget to go check out Alyssa's reactions to the video on WoW Presents channel. Jade in Dior Fierce did Raven. I was left wanting more as it was not a very interesting character to start with. Katia was Susie Orman, a person I have obviously never heard of, although I could guess that she's a big old lesbian. Fucking dykes. Gudu. Pearl was amazing as Big Ange. The subdued lips, the subtle breasts, the glowing skin tone. She was a breath of fresh air. And by that, I mean the last fart of a dead hooker. Cocorico. Kennedy was Little Richard. And this was the first time that I really enjoyed one of Kennedy's performances. She was hilarious and took a big risk by portraying a man. Shut up! Ginger Minj chose to be Adele. And beyond the looks and the British accent, there wasn't much to it. It really bothered me, in Untucked, when Ginger said she was left feeling insecure after one of the judges' comments, saying she was the other white meat. Ginger, you chose to have a plate of food and have Adele stuff her face during the whole of Snatch Game. You cannot have it both ways. No one forced you to play the fat card. The runway theme was leather and lace. As always, I would be a lazy motherfucker and only talk about the looks that I care about. A favorite of many people was Katia's look, but I thought it was too busy. I also think she should invest in some baby powder to get the slutty shine off her wig. Just a thought. Violet was dressed in vinyl, as the poor girl doesn't know what leather is. You cannot have the looks and the brains, apparently. Miss Fame served some Vivian Westwood pointy tits realness. I really enjoyed her looks, it was very polished and glamorous. Jade in Dior Fierce attempted a nude illusion with hot glue, which ended up being a hot mess. She also sewed 25 wigs together and nearly suffocated under the weight of all that hair. I, on the other hand, only have half a wig on my head because I am a broke-ass bitch. during the judge's critique, shut your mouth, who the fuck are you, Braxton, served us the usual girl, girl, blah, 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 blah. Okay, girl, you are loud and tacky and are only famous because of your sister. Good for you. This is the third judge in a row that I really wish hadn't come. Michael Urie, on the other hand, Max did a very weird interruption of the critics, as it was the first time that she was not being praised. Once again, here we have a very young contestant using desperate measures and fails. It is strange how I always liked Max, but in just one episode, I really didn't care for the fact that he was eliminated. I was pretty shocked when it happened though. I really expected Jadine to go home. But I am glad to see her stay one more episode. These eliminations make more sense though when you consider the rumor that all the queens are being brought back in the next episode to compete against each other. The winning contestant will get to come back. This sounds to me like a great idea that will rejuvenate this season. What did you think of this week's episode? In my humble but also important opinion, it was generally better than the rest of the season. Anyway, that's it for today. I shall go back to France to manage the renovation of my castle. It's like I have to do everything myself. Those slaves are completely useless. What am I to do? Don't forget to like this video and to subscribe my channel. Bye bye my lovelies.